Hi, I am really appreciative that this is a forum that brings together practitioners and researchers. And I'm going to myself be an example of a practitioner who is really excited about all of these ideas, but is also struggling with these ideas. And hopefully that will be of benefit to some of you in the audience. So I'm Kelly. I'm from the Santa Monica Public Library. Are there any other public library staff? Woo! So in my position at my library, we do not have a dedicated makerspace. We do not have, I'm running mine. Until just a few years ago, we didn't even have consistent digital literacy programming. So we needed to jump in and start coordinating our efforts. But our day-to-day reality is really dealing with practical concerns and figuring out, you know, how to use the equipment that we've got and how to set up policies for it. So we needed to combine solving a practical concern with some of our strategizing in order to be able to start something and launch something. And one of our practical concerns was that we were having trouble attracting teens. Our teen advisory council expressed a lot of interest in digital literacy programming, in 3D printing, in coding, in other creative applications, but then they would not show up when we would make those opportunities available. And I have plenty of theories about why, but what was interesting was that we were also turning away teen volunteers because apparently we didn't have enough for them to do. And I didn't have enough staff to facilitate digital literacy programming at our library. So I wondered if we couldn't use this to start something. And in order to base our programming on volunteers, we really needed an infrastructure, robust training. We needed to ask for a commitment from them. And in order to ask that much of them, we needed to make sure we were incentivizing their efforts. So we've been doing the tech team program now for 2 years, and it's been a big reason that we've been able to bring programming to our community. Kids coding, adult computer skills, and the community loves it and is benefiting from it. Our hope is that the youth are also benefiting from it. In our community, youth report really high levels of academic expectations and really low levels of meaningful participation in their own learning. And in contrast, in our program, we try to provide examples of success that are social, that are fun, that are authentic in terms of showing the teens the impact they can have on their community. And one thing we definitely see is that they kind of get in touch with themselves and grow in confidence. So we're hopeful that this is a good foundation for some deeper strategizing, specifically related to connected learning, which was part of what inspired me to go in this direction, but that I didn't really fully understand. And now I'm very appreciative of the practitioner's guide that's come out that's given me a strong perspective to reflect in front of all of you so that you can help me clarify anything that I need to clarify. So regarding their interests, they are motivated to learn when they're helping others solve problems. And they have opportunities for creative expression as well, because we encourage them to take on leadership projects and try out their ideas in front of an audience. Regarding relationships, we have the opportunity to really get to know these youth because we're working with them and seeing their strengths and hearing about their interests and helping them find opportunities. And a lot of that is because we have such a structured program. It frees us up to think about the relationships more. But at the same time, that structure, I'm worried, takes away ownership from them, because it's something that we started as a foundation, and I want help thinking about that, and I'm not sure how. Regarding opportunities, We are writing letters of recommendation, helping them connect to academic programs, other enrichment programs, even job opportunities. Teens tell us that they feel like they can say legitimately that they have job experience, but I really want to broker for them more exciting opportunities. They're hungry for them, and I don't have the skills to help them further, and I'm struggling to find the right opportunities for them as well. And just one last big thing I'm struggling with is describing the program. I want to call it service learning, and I don't know if I'm allowed to, if that's too context specific. So I hope that anyone who has insight that they want to share or talk about further with me will find me and talk.